Hello everyone, welcome to the P1 program. This lecture is called P104.4. In this lecture, we are going to introduce the dot product and cross product, which are the multiplication of vectors. So far we have discussed about the addition of vectors, that if you take say a vector A and a vector B, right, if you add those vectors, that means you are going to put a parallelogram just like that, and you will get a resultant new vector, right? So this is how you add two vectors. You can use the parallelogram law or the triangular law of vector addition, depending upon your choice. So why is this significant is when as in the case I discussed earlier, so that if you take a two person connected with a rope, you can see that these people are bound to move in certain axis, certain points. So if one person decides to move in this direction and the other person decides to move in that direction, that means their motion will be resolved. That means their motion will be resolved like this, right? So it will be resolved like this, and you get a resultant vector which looks exactly like that, and the resultant vector would be like this. So this will be the motion. So the resultant will be the motion of the two bodies. And remember that these addition of vectors comes in when all the factors are contributing to the motion. That means there is no factor missing, right? So the component won't be missed, right? No component will be missed. That is when addition and subtraction comes in. If you have opposite vectors, it will cancel out to zero. So if you have vectors like this, it will add up together and become twice as long. So no component is missed is when we do addition, right? So multiplication of vectors is somewhat different. So coming to multiplication, if you say you have a ball like that, and you are going to introduce a force onto that ball, and the ball is going to be hitting on a goal post, right? So if you give the force to that ball, it will move in a straight line and hit the goal post. So the thing that you need to remember is that if you have the line of force in this direction, and the ball is in this point, this axis, it will always be in the direction of the impact, right? The ball cannot change the path after impact. It cannot change, it cannot do that. Okay, so if you give a force in a different direction, that means this is your ball and you give the force in this direction, then some part of the force is being missed out. That means the component of force will miss out. Imagine that you are giving the force in this direction and the ball is right there. So the ball won't move at all. The velocity of the ball will be zero, right? So basically, if you give it in some kind of an angle, some part of the force will be missed out. Okay, remember that. So that missing out has to be imagined, right? So for that, we can resolve the components. We can resolve the components of the force. Say the two vectors of ball. If the force, the ball and force be F and B, right? So what happens is that the component Fx will be added up and Fy will be ignored. So you understand that, right? So if theta is the angle between the two, right? If theta is the angle between the two vectors B and F, right? This is the magnitude of F and this is the magnitude of B, the length. Okay, so you can resolve that component into Fx and Fy, and you have an angle theta in between. Okay, so if that's the case, then you can see what will be the component Fx. The Fx component will add on to B. That's what's going to happen. If you kick the ball with a twice the force, say 2 times force, it will be 2b, right? If it is 3 times, then it will become 3b. If it is 100 times, then it will be 100b. So the vector is going to be multiplied, right? Multiplied by fx, right? It will be multiplied by fx. Fx times b will be the resultant, resultant multiplication, right? So if you multiply f with the b, you will get that, okay, whatever that component be. So let's find out what fx is. So if you look at this triangle, you can see that cos theta, or you can say that cos theta, using trigonometry itself, you can say cos theta must be equal to fx by magnitude of f. So you can say fx will be f cos theta. So you can write down it's f magnitude of f cos theta times b, right? Magnitude of b. So it is f b cos theta. So that is f multiplied with b. This product is called a dot product. Okay, dot product. Okay, this is how you do a dot product. Now, in the dot product, what you get, right? In the dot product, what you get is a number, right? It's a number that says you give a force in this direction and you have a ball here. The component of force will multiply the value of B some factor, right? If it is 2, the B will become 2B. So it will twice, it will be twice the distance. If it is 10, it will be thrice the distance, 10 times the distance. So the force is being multiplied. The force multiplier is called a dot product. And the dot product is evaluated as F dot B must be equal to F B, the magnitude of that cos theta, right? Straightforward. I have proved that. Now you can do it mathematically as well. So for that, for doing this mathematically, what you need is two vectors F and B. Say F is equal to 3x cap plus 4y cap, and B is equal to, these are vectors, 4x cap plus 0y cap. Okay, why 0? Why 0? B is 0 because the ball is restricted to move in one dimension, right? After hitting, it cannot change the dimension. So if you are hitting it at an angle, that means the ball will always move in the x-axis itself, x-cap direction. Okay, that's a, whatever the direction of the ball, that we choose as x direction. Okay, if it is a different direction, then that will be our x direction. So it will not move after hitting. That's a restriction that we are providing, and it will do us a fair job. Now if you use that, you'll get, you all you have to do now is multiply the components, right? If you multiply the components, you get 12 x cap dotted into x cap, right, multiplied by x cap plus 4 times 0 is just 0 y cap multiplied with y cap, right? That's what you get. Now I told you this is a number. So why is it a number? Because x cap times x cap. What does x cap times x cap means? If it is x cap, first x cap is this and the second x cap is that, it's the same thing. Like it has the same magnitude and the same direction. So we told earlier x cap dotted into x cap can be written as x magnitude of x cap times magnitude of x cap times cos theta, right? So theta here is 0, so cos theta will be equal to 0. Cos 0 is equal to 1, right? Cos 0 equal to 1. That means this will be 1, and this x cap, magnitude of x cap, a unit vector, the magnitude of a unit vector will be 1, and also the magnitude of the unit vector will be 1, so it will be equal to 1. So x cap dotted into x cap, it will be equal to 1. So that's a given, that's a given that we can take home, right? So the answer will become 12 times 1, which is 12. So the vector, the ball is being hit with a force which is 3 times 3, which has a component 3, and the fourth component, which is the y cap direction. In the y cap direction, there is 4 factor component, and it is neglected, but only the 3 factor component in the x cap direction is taken, okay, it will contribute to the ball, and the ball will move with a fold of force which is 3 times, right, 3 times the force. So that's what going to happen, and that is cross product, dot product for you guys, okay. That's how you explain dot product. That's the physical aspect and mathematical aspect of a dot product. Now coming into the dot product. Now cross product is something which is entirely different. These are both products, but if you remember determinants, you see determinants, you can find out the determinant of a number, say 3x cap plus 4y cap and 2x cap plus 3y cap, right? These are two vectors, and this determinant can be found out by multiplying, cross multiplying each other, right? So you get 9 minus 8, which is equal to 1. So what does this number gives you? What does the determinant is giving you? What is the physical aspect of determinant? So that's a question. So if you, okay, I'll explain it to you. If you look at the vector, say 1 and 1, 1 and 1, which is a vector, which is 1x cap plus 1y cap, and 1, 0, 1 and 0. So it will look like this and that, right? So the distance here will be 1 because it's 1, 0, and this will be 1 and 1, so that distance will also be 1, right? And this distance, using Pythagoras theorem, you can say it's square root of 2. So what will be the area of this whole thing? It will be half times base into height, right? Base is 1 and height is equal to 1, so it's a half. That's a half area. So what about the resultant of the two vectors? What about the, when you add the two vectors, you get a resultant area, right? If it, this was the vector, first vector and the second vector, you get the area like this, right? The resultant area. What about this area? This area will be twice this one triangle. So it will be half times 2, which is equal to 1. That's the area. Now, this area is called a cross product, okay? This area is a vector. Now, why is it a vector? I'll prove it to you. I'll just find out the determinant. So, a determinant is the area. So, this determinant means the area of these two vectors. Area within these two vectors. A parallelogram connecting the two vectors. The area in between is called the determinant. Okay. So, if I find the determinant of that, right? The same thing. So if you have 1 1 and 1 0, right? So you just find out the determinant. How do you find out the determinant? You can find out if A is 1 1 and B is 1 0, right? A and B, and the determinant will be 0 minus 1, which is equal to -1, right? So that's the determinant. So that's the area. It's a minus area. What does that minus sign mean? Okay, let me give you another thing. If you do BA, right, BA, which means it will be 1, 0 and 1, 1, that determinant will be plus 1. That means the sign have switched. Okay, the sign have switched when you take the determinant of BA. So that means AB, determinant of AB is equal to determinant of BA with a minus sign. So that's a key aspect. So this area, determinant of AB means the area of AB, which is minus 1. Okay. Determinant of BA is the area of BA between BA and for that thing that we have discussed, the 1 and 1. So that's the area within the parallelogram. So the same area when you did in opposite series, opposite like AB and BA, you got different values, different directions for the area, different values, plus 1 and minus 1. So what happens is that this plus 1 means it will be directed in this direction, right? In this direction. Minus 1 means it will be directed in the opposite direction, right? Through the inside, right? You have to imagine this line is going into the board and the other line is coming out of the board, right? So these are opposite directions. So this is a vector. This is an area vector. So cross product is an area vector. Okay, remember that. So cross product is basically an area vector. So how can you find the cross product? Mathematically. So if you look at these two vectors and you get an area like this, this is the area. So how do you find the area? All you have to do is just find the vertical component and the horizontal component. So vertical component, if this is A and this is B, then the vertical component will be B times the horizontal component in that graph. Okay, so that will be the area horizontal. So if you take that, I'll redraw it in a simple manner. So if you, this was A and this was B, you can see that here the vertical component will be, if this A and B, vertical component will be AY, right? The X and Y axis, when we resolve, this is AX, we did that earlier. Now the vertical component will be AY and the horizontal component, if it is AB, then you can find the whole area. It's a slightly bent diagram. Okay, so the whole area can be found out using that. So how can you find out AY, right? You can say this is theta angle. So that means cos theta or sine theta. Sine theta will be equal to AY by magnitude of A, right? That's basic. So AY is A sine theta. So AY is A sine theta. So the area will be horizontal times the vertical. The horizontal we can fix A. You can choose A or B for one side. I choose B here as horizontal component and vertical component I chose it as AY, right? So the area will be AY times B, right? Magnitude of B. So AY is just A sine theta. So the component will be A sine theta times B, the magnitudes. So this will be equal to A B sine theta, right? So that's cross product, A cross B, the magnitude of A cross B. Now that's the area. Okay, that is called the cross product. And if you want to do it mathematically, right, you can write down a vector, say A is equal to 2x cap plus y cap plus 3 z cap, and B is equal to 3x cap plus 2y cap plus z cap. And you can find out A cross B by just taking the determinant, right? Determinant, for taking the determinant, it's a vector, remember. So one piece of the puzzle is to introduce vectors into this equation. So you get x, y, z, y, and x cap, y cap, and z cap, and you introduce the values of the vectors here. You 2, 1, and 3, and 3, 2, and 1, right? So then you find out the determinant. So you get x cap times 1 minus 6, right? 6, that is just minus 5. Minus y cap, it is 2 minus 9, right? So that's y cap times minus 4. And then you have z cap times 4 minus 3, that is just 1. So that's the vector, you got that vector. So it will be minus 5 x cap plus 4 y cap, minus and minus become plus c cap, right? So that's the vector which is called A cross B, which is a determinant. So A cross B is the area between the two vectors of a parallelogram. The parallelogram making the two vectors, that's the area between that, and it is a vector because it has two directions. It can have two directions and we can choose the direction. What will be the other direction? So this is a vector, right? So this vector will look something like this. Okay, imagine that it is coming out of the blackboard. What will be the other vector which is going inside the blackboard? So all you have to do is just put a minus sign. So A cross B must be equal to minus of B cross A, right? So it will be the opposite direction. That's all you need to do. So you get 5 x cap plus 4 y cap, sorry, minus 4 y cap minus c cap. So that's B cross A. Okay, that's B cross A. B cross A will look like that. So that's the two vectors. I hope you understood the foundation, what the theory and the idea behind cross product and dot product, and how can you use it. Okay, you understood how can you use it, where to use it, what's the difference between multiplication and addition and subtraction and all that of the vectors. And I hope this was worth your time watching. Okay, I hope you all the best, and thank you for watching.